So let's discuss a case of a patient with a headache. A 74-year-old woman presents to the emergency department after developing an intensely painful headache that has led to blurry vision and balance abnormalities. Now, pretty much everybody's had a headache at some point in their lives. Let's talk about some of the common types of causes of headaches. In general, we think about vascular causes, infectious, neoplastic, and idiopathic. Let's go through some examples of each. So let's start off by reviewing some vascular causes of headaches. Patients can present with a worst headache of life descriptor, also known as the thunderclap headache, and that may be a harbinger of a subarachnoid hemorrhage, which is certainly an emergent situation. In addition, patients can have either a hemorrhagic stroke or intracerebral hemorrhage or an ischemic stroke. If it's short-lived symptoms, we call that a transient ischemic attack or TIA, whereas if there are sustained symptoms, it's a cerebrovascular accident. In addition, there are infectious manifestations or infectious diseases that can cause headaches. Sinusitis, as in this example here with opacification of the left maxillary sinus, or meningitis, whether bacterial or viral, classically presents with headaches and mental status changes. In terms of neoplastic causes of headache, the two broad categories are primary cancers and then tumors that have metastasized to the brain. Typically, patients who do have brain tumors will present with morning headaches and possibly nausea and vomiting. This figure here highlights the fact that brain tumors can appear anywhere in the brain. Our physical exam is going to help us to hone in on where the abnormality is that would enable us to predict where we would find a lesion when we perform imaging, if it's necessary. And lastly, idiopathic headaches. The most common of which is tension headaches, which are typically band-like in distribution, cluster headaches, which most often manifest with unilateral, ice pick-like retroorbital pain, and then migraines, which are also fantastically common. Patients oftentimes report photophobia or phonophobia, amongst other symptoms as well. So going back to our patient, is this a cerebrovascular accident? Is it a TIA? Does this patient have meningitis, or is this a more benign idiopathic headache? We'll need our physical exam to help to tease apart these different items on our differential diagnosis.